Yeah, that was something unique. Birds are flying. Birds in the sky. Birds are flying. It's Shabbat. It's soon going to be Shabbat this evening. So that is a way to get it straight. We have to better ourselves. I'm not talking to you, my friend. I'm talking to me. I do this video just for me. It's important that we know why we do things. There is something I realized when it was said. I don't know by whom. But everything we do. As for my work or what can I say? That kind of duty or that kind of reason why I did this activism. I did it for myself. In the inspirational period, I think I did it mostly for the objective of changing the systems, changing that service place. It's just a service place that serves the needs of people to interact. In fact, it's just a service that the city council have decided. We agree to this service, and we agree. So maybe the city council understood that everything we do it for ourselves. And I did it because I wanted to have empowerment for those people. But maybe I lacked empowerment myself. Maybe I lacked, I missed out on being empowered. People that I have been talking with doesn't have that sensitivity. So maybe all this kind of noise I made for the good reason. It was out of the need of empowerment for my own sake. And I went a long way to understand how it was done. But even though I continued, I'm continuing. Because I don't see it as an isolated matter. It comes with a lot of defeats. This kind of activism, you have to realize at one point you are defeated. They defeat you and they may slander you and mock you and turn you down and everything of that kind of nature. Yet you keep it on. You have the drive to do it. And I had the drive to do that. I have the drive to talk about Israel, the churches. Now you heard me about the church and the Jews. It is that kind of anti-Semitism I was waking up to it, and it is a gross. I'm not leaving the subject, even though I'm talking about Shabbat, the videos and so on. I do everything. People think that going to church and praise the Lord, do it for their own, do it for other people. And they like to show off. They do it for other people. But I think the deepest sense, if you try to help other people, you try in fact in the end to help yourself. Let me write something here. Let me try this. Everything you do for yourself. Even though it's for the betterment of everybody, you may think the case. You do it for everybody. But I will dispute. I think you do it for yourself. Because it's kind of an excuse to say, I did it for you. If you think that people owe you, like being open, tell about your innermost secrets, not being asked for, then you demand that people that heard your story, you demand that they are equally open. I think the first notion of being open is you do it for yourself. You open in order you do it for yourself. You do it for yourself. I couldn't read. You do it for yourself. That is the hard case here, that you did it for yourself. The church have different. You see, when we congregate, so much sin happens. It's written in a similar term in the Bible where people are talking much. There is a lot of sin. But I think that the heart of that is when people are congregating, when people are coming together, it will be a lot of sin. They do it, they do something they wouldn't else have done. When people are drinking together, they do something, they end up doing something they shouldn't have done, they regret. And when people are talking much together, they talk about things that they regret later on. They shouldn't have talked about it. If you talk about yourself, you have that bad feeling that I said too much to this guy, to this lady. They are slandering. How do they view me? It's all that kind of common feelings that if you say something, you are out there exposing yourself. I think that is not a bad feeling. I think it's a good feeling. It keeps me on the line. I have this feeling always, more or less always, what I ever say can be used against me, and people get furious over what I say. And sometimes when people get furious over what I say, I say, oh, did you understood me now? Did you misunderstood something that I was saying? Because I didn't feel bad about what I said. So what did I say that turned you that way? So it can be a misunderstanding. And if you have this calmness to yourself and you don't feel bad because it was not a retaliation, it was not a revenge, it was nothing bad in what you said, it was just the pure, simple fact what you said. And that can go bad, but if you have this calmness to yourself, it's good. You don't feel bad. You don't said anything wrong. It is the receiver that have to view him or herself objectively. What was that? So the church, yet again, why is that the church can't celebrate Shabbat? I wonder why. Maybe we take some music on just to find out a little bit. Yeah. I didn't find out, but I said to my Christian fellow why don't you celebrate Shabbat? Say openly, like I do. I no longer celebrate Sunday as the Shabbat, the new Shabbat. It's Saturday. I'm not very keen about at what time, as long as it's after sunset. Maybe it goes up to 9 o'clock in the evening. Here it falls at 4 o'clock. But as long as it is within the Saturday, one day I celebrated Shabbat at Saturday evening. I was so confused. I came back from Malaysia, and I was so confused that the whole thing was so weird. So that was a funny event, and I don't ask for Shabbat. I don't do it for God. I do it for myself. If I think that I do it for God, God can be better off by my celebration. He can survive without me celebrating that. But it is me. I do it for myself. And to show the Creator that I honor His resting day. I want to pass that on to me. And in order to, you see, sometimes you have instruments, especially the gauger, some weight gauger, that needed to be calibrated. So every Sunday, every Saturday, Friday, we calibrate. We can calibrate ourselves. It's a good calibration. And when you realize that everything you do for yourself, it should be a good calibration. Why would we calibrate ourselves? Because we are not perfect. Because we are unhappy with ourselves. We are not in equilibrium. We are not in level. We have downs and positives. We have worries. We have all this kind of stuff. So we need to have some circulation. And as I said earlier, the church need to make amends regarding the Jews. Make some major amends, important, better their ways. In order to get on terms, yes, because it's right. It's not to gain the everlasting heaven or something. No, we do things because it's right. We do it because it's good, and it is right to do it. We have no benefit. If you think that I'm preaching the heavenly promise and if you do this and that, you will reach to heaven. No, I have no such a message. If you want to turn to God, if you want to have a better belief system, if you want to have a fail-proof system of belief, you can turn to God. it doesn't give you every answer that way. No, it is a path of life that keeps you on track with yourself. As I said earlier, I don't know whether I can recall it the way I said it, but every break of the commandments, every break of the commandments is some kind of selfish driven overload. I think I will say it like that. It's an unbalanced, uncalibrated, unadjusted, selfish act that you break the law. They break the commandments. If you steal, you have this kind of urge in your egoism that breaks. You can take what is your and what is free and what is given to you. But if you go further on and take what is not yours, that is selfish driven, unlimited selfishness. That is our egoism. I can write it down. Ah, we take a minute. Yeah, I think I got it now. I just had to stop the video just to reflect a little bit. But I wrote something like this. Commandments is for adjusting our ego. And I will put it like that because it is well worked, adjusted, calibrated inner personality, what I can do in order to better myself. So we got the commandments in order to keep us on the track. That is how I would say it. We got the commandments in order to keep us on track. Yeah. Like this. We got the commandments for adjusting our ego. That is well said, as I... that is how I would say it. And I think it is well put. And I think church need to follow some of those commandments. It's written, you should keep Shabbat holy. And would the giver of Shabbat change the day? No. It's important for a Christian because he is a believer. He is the pure drop of believing. To always look if he is on the track. Not to show himself at the temple as the Pharisees did. No. That is show off. I can't stay here. I can't expose myself in order for me to try to get you to believe that I am better than I am. No, I'm the false prophet, remember? I am the false prophet. I am the false That's good. I am nothing more than a vessel, than a sound in the multitude of tech. I'm just a sound of tech. Who would believe that this guy from early stages will sit here. Now 1 year I am celebrating, maybe 2 years soon, to celebrate that I've been doing these videos. I didn't think much of that, but since I have this stiffness in my shoulder, and when I start writing, I can't continue. So I have my voice, I have my lips, and as long as I as a Christian can bless Israel, as long as there is breath in my mouth, as long as I can talk, I will talk so that you are waking up. I do it for myself. I want to wake up my friend. I want to wake up to a new morning, a new day that shines on us, given from the God Almighty. People that doesn't believe in God, they believe in all sorts of different stuff. That is the alternative. That is their alternative. As the Christians do, they believe in some different alternatives when they don't get the track right. When they can't bless Israel, they believe all sorts of bullshit. Sorry for that expression, but it is. It is that bullshit that people can't do without. To bless Israel, keeping you on track, to try at least to keep one commandment, it keeps you on track. Don't make excuses for not keeping the rest. Don't use my words against me and for you. No, use whatever you can. I don't care about your life. I'm just kidding. You see, it is important for the equilibrium to attain equilibrium that we keep the commandments, keep the Shabbat, keep the Easter. All God's commands. On these 316, I don't know. They have some foot and yards they can't walk. I'm not a Jew, so I can't keep track on that. But they have been obedient to all his commandments. So why are the Christians so high and mighty over themselves? I think they do it for themselves. To feel good, feel better than the Jewish brethren. It is kind of a mockery of themselves. If I think that I am better than you, I do a mockery of myself. This is out of order. It should never be that I look down on you. Either I can take you or I can't. Sometimes someone I can't take. That's how simple my life is. Someone I can't take. Someone I can. It goes to that limit, and that's that. I can't see any future. So that's how gross that is. I'm a simple guy, but I never think I'm better than anyone. Ask them. I'm interested in chess, by the way. In somewhat limited way. There, if you are playing with a kid as a grown-up, if you are playing with a kid and you think, oh, this little guy doesn't really understand and he is not as smart as me, you will be tricked. You will be fooled. Because Magnus, when he was at the age of 8, maybe 12, he could play out the most famous, best chess player in the world. I think he was 12 by that that time. He played a Jewish guy in Russia. At that time, he was playing Kasparov or someone Jewish smart guy, because the Jews have this tradition of this game. And Bobby Fischer was maybe the most genius of them all. He was a Jew. He died later on, after his game at Reykjavik in Iceland. So, my friends, calibrate yourself. It's due time. Do it for yourself. Do good because it's right to do. Change to the better because it's right. It's the right thing to do. You are not promised rewards and so on. But to bless Israel is attached with a blessing on you. And you reminded me that when I was in Israel with my daughter, he said, it's told to the Gentile, if you bless Israel, you will be blessed. That is a definite promise. So don't bless Israel because of that, but everyone, I bless Palestinians. I bless my enemies. Who is that? I don't know. I bless you, my friends. I bless you with shalom, the shalom of the peace from God. Keep on track, keep your equilibrium, and you will be good. I wish you all Shabbat shalom. God bless you.